Good morning, everyone. It's a great privilege for me to address in such a huge gathering, and actually in Gauhati University. I thank Professor Kalita sir for inviting me as a resource person. I am from Arunachal Pradesh, and today I'll be sharing about the wildlife resources in Arunachal Pradesh with special reference to cultural rituals, which the topic has been given by me. So I am Neelam Yania, as I told. So we go to Arunachal Pradesh for some time, for an hour now. So I have been told that we have friends from other parts of Northeast also. So for their convenience, I'll be speaking about the emergence of Arunachal Pradesh. My esteemed member from Northeast, they'll be knowing about Arunachal Pradesh, how it emerged, but for esteemed member from other parts of the country. So emergence of Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh was an unexplored hidden land since time immemorial. We were neither the yoke of China or India, but we had lived in free style and independently. Only the barter system were there with China, Myanmar, Bhutan for salt and other things like brass plate. We have this in locally we call Marsh Tal, that is the ornaments, belt, bell, and from India for clothes, yarn, etc. We traded in barter system. But in 1954, we have been given the name as Northeast Frontier Tract by administrative regulation. Then again in 1957, it has been renamed as Northeast Frontier Agency. But agency, it does not sound a name for a state. So the then governor of Assam, B.K. Nehru, at that time, before independence, we were part of Assam. So Assam is our elder brother. So at that time, different names were suggested. Instead of Northeast Frontier Agency, different names like Arunachal Pradesh, Uttarachal, Brahma Mandal were suggested by the council. But B.K. Nehru, he zeroed down to Arunachal Pradesh. So this agency council was replaced by Pradesh Council in 1972. And finally in 1987, we are the 24th state of India as Arunachal Pradesh, from Union Territory to statehood. So this is the emergence of Arunachal Pradesh in Indian state. So Arunachal, it is the easternmost part of India where the sun rises first in the Indian soil. That is at 4:30 a.m. a place called Dong, where the sun rises first. Then the total area of Arunachal is 83,743 square kilometers. And my friends from Northeast, they will be knowing that we have international boundary with China, with Myanmar and Bhutan, and interstate boundary with Nagaland and Assam in the south. We have 26 major tribes, some of which the photograph I'll be showing, and we have 110 sub-tribes and some minor tribes in our place. Most of the native of Arunachal Pradesh, we are from the same Mongoloid stock or the same stock of Tibeto-Burman origin, who share the same language, history and culture. Ethnically, we are derived from the same stock, but geographically, we are located in different places. So isolation, because of this geography, it has brought in differences in our custom, in our dress and in our language also. So you can see here, the first row is in the western part of Arunachal Pradesh. The tribes in the western part of Arunachal Pradesh, like Nishi, Apatani, Galo, the first one, lady with the white dress is Galo, and with the black dress, she is the Agi. Then we have Akka. Then in second row, these are from the eastern part of Arunachal Pradesh, Wangcho, Thangsa, Singh, 4, and Lisu is the minor tribe in our state. So this is the map showing the districts in Arunachal Pradesh. We have 22 districts. Just this month itself, we have 21. This month, in December 2017 itself, a new district was created from Lower Subansiri, bifurcated from Lower Subansiri, Kamla district, just 3 weeks back. So we have 22 districts. So here it may show around 18, but from places it was bifurcated, like Kurumkame, now it's Karnataka and Kurumkame. I'm sorry for the old map, but I could not get the latest one. So now we come to the biodiversity, the topic which I have been given, the wildlife. So biodiversity, so before going to particularly in Arunachal Pradesh, we know that in world there are 35 hotspots and our Northeast India is one of them, one of the hotspots of the world. And in terms of area, Arunachal Pradesh is the largest in Northeast India. So obviously most of the areas in Arunachal Pradesh comes under the hotspot, which I'll be explaining in coming slides. And World Wildlife Fund has also identified the entire Eastern Himalaya as one of the priority global 200 ecoregion all over Northeast. Then it lies at the transition zone of Indo-Chinese, Indo-Malayan and part of Indo-Burmese. And because of this location, this area, it depicts the law of interspersion. If we use in a simple language, we can see the edge effect, where the instead of the participating region, the edges has the more diversity than the participating regions. And because of this unique biodiversity, the whole of Northeast, we have gained the status of mega biodiversity hotspot in the world. In the world, there are only 12 mega diversity hotspots, and among them, we are one of them, mega diversity hotspots in the world. So this is a map showing the vegetation density of Arunachal Pradesh. We have different types of vegetation, very dense vegetation, moderately dense vegetation, open forest. Some of the photographs I'll be showing. And regarding the dense forest coverage, we are the largest in the country with 81.2% in regarding dense forest. Other than in forest coverage, we come after Madhya Pradesh only, but in dense forest, we come largest in our country. So this is our vegetation map. And as for champion and shade, we have 6 forest types in Arunachal Pradesh according to the altitudinal range. Like up to 600 meters, we have tropical semi-evergreen forests. For my friends who are from other background, who are not from the botany or geology, I'll be showing the photograph of this vegetation also to make you more clear. And up to 900 meters, we have tropical red evergreen forests. Then from 900 to 1900, subtropical broadleaf forests. Then from 1000 to 1800 meters, we have subtropical pine. Then above 1800 up to 3500, we have temperate. And above this is the alpine forest. Then these are some of the important plant species. You may take this slide and you can see on your own. So without wasting much of the time, we'll go to the photographs. These are the tropical forests. This is comes at 6,000 to 900 meters above mean sea level. So this is the photograph of tropical forest in our state. Then this is the wet evergreen forest. It is up to 900 meters. Then this is the subtropical broadleaf forest. At 900 to 1900 meters above mean sea level. Then this is subtropical fine forest. This photo has been taken from Lower Subansiri in the Achuli area. There are lots of pine trees there. So this is at 1000 to 1800 meter of mean sea level. This is the temperate broadleaf forest. So I want to share something about this slide. This is a very unique thing in a place. There is a wildlife sanctuary known as Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary, one of the youngest declared wildlife sanctuary in our state. It was just declared in 1995, covering up area of 337 square kilometers from the reserve forest. The beauty of this wildlife sanctuary is that, if you can see in this photograph also, this was taken by myself when I was doing my research in this sanctuary. Generally, broadleaf forests, they are below and above are the coniferous forests. But in this, it has the vice versa. Different forest type. Here, when the broadleaf is in the top, in the higher belt, and the coniferous in the below belt, which is not usually in other parts. So this is the uniqueness about this Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary, and I'll be sharing more about the sanctuary in the coming slide. This is altitude of 1800 to 3500 meters above the mean sea level. This is a subalpine forest. This is at above 3000 meters. And this is the alpine forest, above 3,500 meters of mean sea level. Then now looking at the flora at a glance in our place, we have angel sperm of around 5,000 species expected. The gymnosperm, we have around 34 species, fern and bryophyte about 350 species, bamboo, it is written 73, but now there are more. More than this we have, then again also we have 18 species, medicinal plants, lots of medicinal, the expected is that 450 species are there, and obviously it is known as the land of orchid also. We have more than 500 orchid species, and this contributes to 33% of total flora of India. That's why we are also known as the cradle of speciation for the flora. So this is the largest tree complex of Arunachal Pradesh, because Elastica. It looks like a different tree, but it's a single tree. This is the largest tree of Arunachal Pradesh. Then as I told about the bamboo, we have more than 70 plus bamboo. These are few of them I'm showing, only around 4 species. We have Bambusa balqua, which we call Baluta. Then we have Bambusa bambus, that is the Kataba. In Assamese we call Kataba. Then Bambusa chachariensis. Then Bambusa polymorpha. These are just very few slides. But I won't be highlighting about all this bamboo. I just want to highlight about Bambusa bambus, that is the Kataba. Kata itself is thorn. This bamboo, it bears lots of thorn. And this bamboo, it has been used as a biofencing between the boundary of India and Bangladesh. And the sapling for these bioresources, it has been biofencing, it has been collected from our state. We have a place known as Sesa, there we have lots of bamboo. Only 75 species, it's written 73, but we have 75 species there. In a place, bamboo system, we have cultivated it as a sample. So I welcome all of you, come sometime to our nature and see all the bamboo which we have. The sapling for that boundary as a biofencing, it was taken from that, from Sesa. It's such a thick and with thorns that nobody can cross easily. I think it's almost impossible to cross. You can see here also. So this is about the bamboos. Then cane, we have 18 species. Here I'm showing only 3 of them. We have jati bat, that is Calamus tenius. We have hati bat and super rider. And as our Assamese friend all will be knowing, we make furniture, bridges, and all the items from these bats, all the decorative items.